Hello guys, today continue follow Justice Ace Attorney. So in the last video, we in the part where we talk to Mr. Misham about the diary. Lawood 3. Okay, so I can do open the lock here, so I'm just gonna go elsewhere. I'm just gonna go elsewhere and search. Okay. Oh, wait. Oh, I see. Oh, I can open this. Okay, try the tension. Wait. Can I open the thing? I forgot what its name. Defendant lobby number 2. You know what? Try defendant lobby number 2. Ah, call record. Nice, okay. Wait! I want to press the record, then check. Okay, we try to open the lock. He try to hide the finishing lock. The disappearing trick. Okay, Mr. Mickens. What do you know? Spit it out. Hey, what's this atmosphere in here all of a sudden? You know something, and I'm going to find out what. Zed Gamery vanished from this room. How he do it? How, sir? Well, sir, I can say I, sir. Why are you so nervous if you're unhiding anything? If you're unhiding something. Well, sir, you see, at the time, sir, I was here and... Listen, it was impossible! What could such a little girl possibly do anyway? What did you just say? Sir, did I just say something, sir? No, you screamed it through that megaphone of yours. There was someone else in the room, wasn't there? Sir, I'm going to have to invoke my right to remain in a state of not talking. It's okay, Mickens. You don't have to tell me who Zack accomplice was. I know who was here in this room that day. Present? Sir, I never seen that girl until just the other day. Mr. Mickens, I'm not buying it. Sir, that day she was here in the room, sir. But he wasn't. You mean you chased her into this room, not him? Sir, in my days as a police officer, literally days, I learned a thing or two. Okay, just one thing, but it was how not to mistake a girl for a 7-foot-tall magician. 7 feet? Zack isn't that tall, is he? You have a point. I find it hard to imagine that anyone would mistake a little girl for a Zack Gamery. But you saw something. And therein lie the tricks. I think you know what it was, Mr. Mickens. Tell me, does this trick look familiar? Listen. Oh. What's that? That girl's favorite trick, the amazing Mr. Hat. She used it in her show down at the Wonder Bar. Have you been to the Wonder Bar? So, it wasn't a waking dream, was it, sir? Come again? That night on stage, I saw a vision, except it wasn't a vision, it was a hat. An amazing Mr. Hat! He really exists! Nice! Yay! The vanishing trick. I remember it clearly, though the details are a little vague. The Gamery exited the courtroom. I gave chase and cornered him in the corner room, sir. Zed Gamery, don't even think you can escape, Mickens. Down on your hands, floor on your head. Hello? Something's the matter, mister? No, that is... Sir, I'm currently chasing a suspect, sir. Zed Gamery, do you know him? Oh, I love Zed Gamery. His magic is the best. I'm his biggest fan. I see. That's why you're wearing that costume you're wearing? Anyway, that very Zed came into this room. But no one's been in here except me. But he has to be in here somewhere. Under the sofa in the trash can behind the painting under the rug. So, Tracy was his accomplice. Imagine my astonished surprise when, 1 week later, I just happened to walk into a bar and see him! Mr. Head, I couldn't believe my own eyes! For a while, I thought it had all had been a long dream. A dream that lasted a week. But it wasn't the magician who disappeared, it was Mr. Head. The trick finished? Though it seemed complex, what really happened that day was quite simple. You were standing by the door, out came Zack. But that wasn't all. Another person got in on the egg, and she was standing in front of lobby number 2. And along with Mr. Head. Ah, and that's the beauty of it, isn't it? So, while you are standing in the shock and amazement, the magician round the corner, and most likely runs through the closest door into lobby number 1, this is where you come in. You turn the corner in rather lukewarm pursuit. And at the very moment, Tracy runs into lobby number 2. Then all she has to do is tuck away the amazing Mr. Head. Sarai, I only lost sight of him for the briefest of moments. Then I saw that cape, Zed Gamery. Red cape fluttering like a cape. Astounding, sir. All my days of posing queries and making inquiries and chasing queries wasted. It was as if I could see them melting away like an ice cream cone left by the side of the road to die. Or the scattered remains of a messily eaten chocolate parfait. Such sweet sorrows. I'm sorry. I had no idea how much you suffered on account of this case. It's an honor, sir. I've apologized to people many times, sometimes more than once. But this is the first time anyone ever apologized to me. Actually, about that girl, I'm sort of her guardian now. Is that so? Sir, you should know that I harbor no ill feelings whatsoever in my harbor. Okay. I let the defendant escape, that's the stone cold truth. It's another step on my way from singing the blues to wearing my blues. Someday shall I be standing side by side with the great Detective Gumshoe! Mr. Mickens, this is a free ticket to the show at the Wonder Bar. If you want it. It's an honor, sir! Sir, I can't count the number of things I have taken from me, sir. But no one's ever given me anything for free! Right, I see you in the courtroom next time then, sir. I look forward to it. Ah, finally done this part. All eyes were on Zed Gamery that day in court until his mysterious disappearance. No part of the mysteries been revealed, but the magician remained out of sight. It would be 7 years before I met him again. Okay, nice. Defendant lobby number 2 is done. Ooh! Interesting. Yay, new place. Present day, Bosch Ball Club. Oh? Oh, it's been so long to see him! I'll be taking my leave now. Still have some work to do back at the office. Then I guess I go back to my piano. To be honest, it's better when you are playing. This frigid culinary dungeon almost feels comfortable. Later then. Hour left on my shift. I'm not if you get any customers tonight. Ahem. Do you know who I am? Who I am? No, but if you hum it, I can play it. Just kidding, I don't do requests. Oh, but a different sort of request. You see, I play cards. Oh, a customer? I was just hoping someone would come in and save me from a night at the keys. I seek a true competition. I have heard the boss ball club is the place for this. Now I see the rumor is true. And this is a friend of yours? Oh, don't mind me. I'm just your friendly neighborhood newsman. He will not be playing tonight. When his business is finished, I shall send him. When his business is finished, I shall send him home. This competition will be between us, no others. The Right Talent Agency represents two artists, and I'm number two. I play piano. Well, sort of. It's actually just a front for my real talent, which is playing poker. Don't ask me how I got started, I don't remember. But I'm good, real good. It didn't take long for the rumors to get around. Go to the Burst Ball Club if you want a real game. That guy's never lost. People don't come to hear me tickle the ivory, they come to watch me play cards. Is this a silly poker club? No, it's a restaurant. We don't play for high stakes. There's no money involved. But real players carry cash and they're always thirsty. It's a handy source of income for the club owner. Then, let's compete. I take you to the room. The hideout, yes. But before we go, yes. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Shady Smith. Oh, and I'm Bruchel. Spark Bruchel, news reporter. Oh, I'm... No. Phoenix, right? Huh? You must always look a man in the eye when you make your introduction. You still do not know who I am? Have we met? Ah! Wait. So does that mean Christoph killed Zack Gamry? Huh. Okay. You can't be, but you're Zack Gamry? Yes, the reincarnation egg of the century. Pity I only have an audience of one. You, Zack Gamry? This must be a bad dream. In a sense, this guy ruined my life. You there? We will play soon. Ready the room. I will be preparing the hideout for you. Wait, I forgot. Is it Christoph or Olga? Oh wait, it's Christoph, yeah. Are you really him, the Zack Gamry? Now I am Shady Smith. Remember this. How many years has it been now? 6? And exactly 3 days from now, it will be 7. I caused you so much inconvenience, I fear. Yeah, you could say that. Is she well? Tracy, I mean. She's fine. I've got her working already, hope you don't mind. I hardly need express my gratitude, but you have it. This is why I have come. That and to settle a matter of cards. By which you mean poker? Those eyes! He's serious! I despise losing above all else. And so I have decided that I will win tonight, no matter what it takes. I know this guy's type and they're dangerous. Everything's about the competition, all else is secondary. Perhaps we should take this time to talk before we play. I know you have much to ask me. And I you. Yay! Finally! Ah! Yay! Talk. The meaning of competition? We competed that day 7 years ago too. Ah yes, you must have been surprised. Called to the detention center out of the blue. Two. One. Chose your defense attorneys by playing poker. Some are hired, others fired. When you compete, you see a man's true nature. You know what I speak of. I know that you do. Tracy's power? Tracy, she is in a class of her own. For 7 years, I've played poker here at the Borscht Ball Club. I win because whenever there's a big game, I bring in Tracy. And she sends me signals. Hey, he's got a good hand. You might have a chance if you act quick. Better call him soon. Can you tell me what her power is? Judging a person's thoughts by reading their reaction is a staple of performance magic. But those of Tracy's line possess far greater skill. Her line? Recall you were the second man to whom I lost. Magnifique Gamery. That was the first time I learned of this power, as you call it. Wait, so you're saying her power is genetic? It's just in the Gamery's blood or something? Blood? Relock. Okay. I am sorry, but it is not something taught lightly to outsiders. And it is nothing you need to know at this time. It's some kind of gambling secrets then. Fine. About Tracy? She's 15 this year. She's still trying her best to follow in your footsteps, you know. I see. When I planned my disappearing act, it was the thought of her alone that gave me pause. Wait! You were planning on finishing from the get-go? Yes, and for that I must apologize. However, I could not be found guilty that day. Because of this. This? A transfer of right. You see the signature? A transfer? That's Magnifique Gamery's signature, isn't it? I hereby give all right to secret staging and performance of my magic to recipient named below, recipient Zack Gamery. Name below, and the recipient's name is you, Zack Gamery. Yes, it is I. Wait, this page looks torn. You recall the diary, yes? First, take a close look at this diary. Note that the page has clearly been ripped out. As it just so happens, I have her here what I believe to be the missing page. But wait, let me see that. How could I forget? That scrap of paper lost me my attorney's badge. This is the real page that was torn from the book. And if he gave it to me that night. You could have told me this earlier, like 7 years earlier. Once again, I must apologize. It was all I could do to prepare for my escape from that courtroom. Transfer of rights. The greatness of Magnific Gamery's illusion are thwarted. As such, they are well protected by this document. Amidst Bearer may perform his illusion on stage. Sounds like a pretty important thing to have if you're his disciple. As the rightful heir to his heart, I too wanted a rightful heir. Rightful? I'm sure you know who I choose as my successor. Your daughter? That is why I have reached out to come here tonight. Rochelle? Sir? Ah, here you go. What's this? A letter passing the right I have inherited to trustee. I will have you sign here as a witness. But I'm not a lawyer anymore. And you need a public notary besides. Ah, I may not look at it, but I'm a certified notary. You are? By day, I wear a notary glasses and hunt for news. Also by day, I wear a reporter glasses and notaries. When I take off the glasses, I can see very well. Your signature, please. This is the first reason I have come here tonight. You know, I for some reason feel like this guy kind of like to complicate things. Ah, I see. I finally figured it out. I finally figured it out. Now I know why you come out of hiding only now. It's been 7 years, you said. Precisely. There's a law that covers your situation. After 7 years, missing persons are considered to be legally deceased. So if someone was to vanish from the face of the earth 7 years ago, they would lose all rights as a living person after 7 years from that day. Not to mention all of their possessions. Exactly, which is why I'm here. I risk showing my face in public for the sake of this document. Before my 7 years are up, you might say I am securing my daughter's inheritance. But do you really need this? Do you really need this document? Can't trustee inherit your estate automatically? Not in this case, I am afraid. In this case, yes, I received the performance right from Magnific Gamery. However, this was done in secret without witnesses. Before Magnific died, two potential successors to his reports here were named. Myself, Zack Gamery, and Fallon Gamery. Not trusty. Okay, that's it for today's guys. Bye-bye!